to yet another worship experience. My name is Crystal.
And I'm Wallace.
So no matter where you're watching from this morning, we welcome you. And if this is your first time joining us here at Dare to Imagine, we want you to know that you are considered a VIP. Amen. That's right. If you don't know what that means you are considered a very important person here at Dare to Imagine. So we'd like for you to go to d2ic.org/guest so that we can provide you with some resources to get you started.
Absolutely. We want to get to know you, and we want you to be able to get to know how to get involved here at Dare to Imagine Church. Today is going to be an amazing Sunday because it's Pastor KJ's birthday week. And we are so excited because we are going to do something special for him today.
Yes. So before we get to that, you guys know what today is. It's Sunday. So that means it is Selfie Sunday.
Yep.
So no matter where you are or who you're with, grab that person, take a selfie, and go ahead and put it on your social media.
Absolutely. And because we are celebrating Pastor KJ this week, we want you to not only tag the church, but also tag Pastor KJ. You'll see his handle right there on the lower third, at DRKRJ.
Yes. And so we'll definitely show your pictures a little bit later in our Chop It Up segment, so stay tuned for that.
Absolutely.
And again, we want to thank you for joining us for this amazing worship service that you don't want to miss. And if you are tuning in for the first time, we want to connect with you. And we have a very special person here at Dare to Imagine. Her name is Christine Dancy, and she will help you and direct you through the community and all the programs that we have here at Dare to Imagine.
Absolutely. So you'll see her contact information again right there on the bottom of the screen. So definitely make sure you field all your questions to her so that she can get you to the right place.
Yes. We're doing something a little different this morning. We got a game, Wallace.
A word?
Yes. It is called Dare to Imagine. Oh, I think I messed that one up. D2I trivia, y'all. So we're going to kick it off by asking a couple questions. They're going to be biblical. They're going to be about Dare to Imagine. It's going to be fun, but there's a kick to it. So if I get it right and you get it right, we got to put on D2I gear, and then we got to choose someone to give it away to.
If
we get it wrong, then we still gotta put on the D2I gear. But we don't get to keep it, unfortunately.
All right, so let's jump right in. So, Crystal, here's our first question. In what year was Dare to Imagine founded?
Ooh, that's a good one. I'm going to go with 2013?
2012.
Oh, 14, right?
Oh, 2014. 14? Yeah.
Okay, wow. Oh, I was trying to study so I can get that right.
All right, so go ahead, throw this one on.
All right, put the nice little... What is this here?
It's a nice D2I scarf you got on.
Okay, are my curls still popping with it on?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. All right, I got a question for you, Wallace. Where was the first Dare to Imagine service held at?
That's a good one. I'm going to guess it was at Pastor Johnson's house and Sister First Lady Kimya.
Oh, I'm so happy to do that. Actually, it was held at Dr. Jerry Johnson's house, and that was a remarkable time, we know.
Absolutely.
You got to put some gear on. You can't skip. Which one do you want? Get the hat? Oh, and this might go well with it, too. You got your nice little scarf like me.
Okay, let me throw that on, too.
Yep. Looking good. Oh, all right. Ooh, got me there. It's okay.
All right, let's go into question three. Ready?
Yep.
All right, so how many books are in the New Testament?
Oh, boy. I'm going to say... Sorry, Pastor K, did I get this wrong? 28?
Close. I believe there's 26. 27.
Again, I got it wrong. Oh, man. It's okay.
I'm going to throw on this D2I blanket.
Ooh, yeah, so cozy. Cold outside. Now I'm feeling cozy. This is awesome. Can y'all see that?
Look at that.
Yes. So we got one more question.
Hit me.
You better get this one right.
All right.
What is a Dare to Imagine? What is the question? What is a Dare to Imagine mission?
Right. So this one I think I got. So our mission is to connect folks to Jesus Christ and help them to live their best life for God.
Yeah. You better go ahead.
I know my church.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. But look, still put on some gear.
No,
got,
let me get my blanket.
Got you a cool blanket too to go with. With the swag there.
Swagged out.
Look, we got to get ready for this weather out here. So know what's next, Wallace.
All right, so we want you to get to know everything that's happening here at Dare to Imagine Church. So let's just jump right into our new segment called
What's Happening?
All right, so as you know, it is Black History Month all month long. So we want to pay respect to our ancestors and the giants who came before us and really paved the way for our community.
Yeah, so we'll kick it off this week with the late, the great, the beautiful Cicely Tyson. As many of you guys know, Cicely Tyson was a pioneer, a giant in the theater industry. She's African-American, and she was an award-winning film actress, as well as she was notable for a lot of her roles and that we've all come to know and love, which was the autobiography of Miss Jane Patterson.
Absolutely. So Miss Tyson was born in New York City and grew up right in the Harlem area of the city. And then in the 1960s, she rose to become a premier Black African-American actress.
Yeah. In addition, Cicely Tyson was known for her community service through her. She actually co-founded a dance theater there in Harlem and received numerous acting awards and nominations, and also became a member of the Black Filmmakers Hall of Fame in 1977.
That's so awesome. So we know just a few short weeks ago, Cicely Tyson passed away on January 28th. She remains a pillar of our community, and we just want to say, as the Dare to Imagine church community, that we salute you, Miss Cicely Tyson.
Yes, rest in peace. So, moving forward, we want you guys to mark your calendars, because we have so much going on here at Dare to Imagine. So, first things first, you got to go ahead and mark your calendars for February 26th. It's coming fast, because that's going to be our family night with our Kids Zone here at Dare to Imagine.
Absolutely. And then, don't forget, on March 7th, we have not only D2I Day, and I'm so excited for that, but we are also launching the registrations for our next semester of iGroups. And we all know how impactful and transformational those iGroups are, so can't wait to sign up for that.
Yes. And last but not least, April 4th. You got to mark your calendars for that, because we are back with Praise in the Park.
Hey.
And it's going to be on Easter Sunday. So that's April 4th. We're going to be outdoors, ready to praise God. And we know how Praise in the Park is. It's always such a great time.
Absolutely. So make sure you bring your lawn chairs, your blankets, your water, your Bible, and then we want you to bring at least 5, 6, 7 people with you. We have the whole lawn to fill up, so we want to make sure we pack the house for Praise in the Park.
Yes, and so we have this cool gear on, but we forgot to mention that we are actually going to give this gear away to someone who is right now dropping the chat, I want some gear, because we're going to pick you, and we're going to make sure that you get this gear. So I don't know about you guys, but I know today's going to be exciting. I know Pastor KJ is excited, and so it sounds like this is all we have for that media team today. Yeah,
we'll see you later.
All right,
hallelujah. Come on
everybody, clap your hands if you know the Lord is good. Hey. Come on, if you're watching online, stand up on your feet.
From every nation
and from
on from the top, y'all. Lord, you are good to me.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
Say, Lord, you are good. Come on.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
Say, people from every nation. Here we go.
People from every nation.
Say, from generation.
Sure. the sick, and you raise the dead. You cause the blind to see, 'cause you're a miracle worker. You're a miracle worker. You're a miracle worker. 'Cause you're the God of miracles, signs, and wonders. You're the God of miracles. You
you are yet to perform, God. I know that you're getting ready to do something in our country with this COVID-19, because God, we know that you have your hand on your children, God. You have your hand on this world, God. And as long as we can turn to God and we look to the hills that which cometh our help, we know that God has got us. Amen? Amen. Dare to imagine, good morning. Good morning. It is so good to see you all here in the sanctuary, but also everyone viewing online. I am Krista. I just want to say hello, good morning, but also I want to say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for just being amazing members of this amazing church. In my opinion, we have the best church in the world. Am I right? We have the best church. Not only do we have the best church, but we have the best pastor in the world. Pastor KJ is just an amazing man of God. But it is because of you, and it is because of you that we can do these things here in church. And it is because of your offering, and it is because of your tithes and you being so obedient to God. So right now, we want you to give the way that I give, and that's via PushPay. All you need to do is text D2I Church app to 77977. And while you're at it, go ahead and sign up for reoccurring. Because I will say, I'm a reoccurring giver. And I challenge you to become a reoccurring giver. Amen. I am so excited. Let's hit it up with some joy this morning. I am so filled with joy this morning. I am so excited. Come on and put your hands together this morning.
Everybody clap your hands. Come on. Hey. If you've got joy, give him the glory today. Give him the honor today. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Song goes like this. There's beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain. There's freedom though you captured me. I've got joy instead of
deep in my soul.
Down deep in my
down
soul.
Down deep in my soul.
You give me say.
You give me joy.
Down deep.
Down deep in my soul.
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 Oh, there's beauty, say.
Beauty in my brokenness.
Say, I've got true love.
I've got true love instead of pain.
There's freedom though you
there's
capture
freedom,
me.
You capture me.
Say, I've got joy.
I've got joy instead of mourning.
Oh, there's beauty.
Beauty in my brokenness.
Say, hey. I've got true love.
I've got true love.
Good morning, Santa. How many know we've got you?
There's freedom though you capture me.
So whether you in person or online, we pray that you, as how many know, worker, yes he is, and so we've been able to do so many things in our communities, in the lives of individuals, in the lives of churches, and in the lives of folks throughout not only the city of Philadelphia, the state of Pennsylvania, this country, but we've been able to pour into folks and have impact because of you. So right now, we want to be able to continue that work, which we will be doing over the course of the next few months as we go into our Lenten season, as we go into Dare to Imagine Day. We want to make sure that we're continuing to pour into people. Yeah. So you can help us do that by texting 77977 and putting in the words D2I Church app, giving via push pay for Expand the Vision. You just simply got to type in 77977, put Expand the Vision in that note, and we will be able to continue to give impact. So while you do that, let's hear a little bit more of some worship, and we'll be right back.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Never been more secure knowing your heart, Lord. I never been so free, Lord, in your love for me. Never been more secure knowing your heart, Lord. Oh, never been so free, Lord, in your love for me.
Never been more secure.
And if you're joining with us, stand up wherever you are as we thank God for these gifts. Dear God, we're grateful for the gifts that you have given to each and every one of us and for the gifts that have been shared with Dare to Imagine. May they continue to bless so many and to change lives. May God, you be glorified in all that we do and all that we say, and in all that we give. For it's in your name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. Well, today is a special day. It's a special day in not only the life of Dare to Imagine, but frankly, right here in our family. So as you all know, I'm Kimia. I am married to Pastor KJ. He is my boo, right? Yes. And today is the day that we have set aside to celebrate his birthday. So February 12th, Friday is his birthday. Come on out here, honey. We have some special things planned, and we know that we will enjoy this. So, honey, you just sit here. We're going to shower you, and we want you to enjoy this. So let's check out this video.
Hey y'all, for those who don't know, my name is Pastor KJ. And I kind of run stuff around here. The house. This is the stage up here. And I just love God. And we have lots of fun here, Dare to Imagine. But it's not always fun and games. Things can get complex. New scripts, Zoom calls, and lots of meetings.
Hello, good people.
Pastor KJ, we really need to get this meeting on your schedule. The group wants to meet with you this week. Do you have a day? What time? What day?
Hear me all right? All right, that's good.
Mm-hmm. I'm listening. Mm-hmm. I'm listening.
Mm-hmm. But Dare to Imagine, I love y'all so much. Now just have a few more words for y'all, and I'm done for the day. Let's take a look.
Beloved. But I'm gonna give you the KJ remix. Talk to me today. And beloved, listen, and if you're really honest with yourselves today, beloved, if I'm really honest with you today, beloved, beloved, oh, I wish I had some people right now in the chat. Somebody put right there in the chat, beloved. And what I want you to understand today, beloved, put it in the chat. Come on, put it right there in the chat. Beloved, have I got a witness in here today? Yes, beloved. See, if we're really honest today, beloved. And beloved, and then this last thing, and I'm done for the day. And if we're really honest with ourselves, beloved, see, beloved, have I got a witness in here today? Today, beloved, come on, put something right there in the chat, beloved. But can I go ahead and shout you right quick? Come on, put it right there in the chat. You ought to just put that right there in the chat. Can you put that in the chat? Right there in the chat. Put it right there in the chat. Yes, beloved, come on, put it right there in the chat. Come on and put right there in the chat. Life is better when we dare to imagine.
All jokes aside, thank you for all you do for Dare to Imagine and inspiring us to keep growing. Happy birthday, Pastor KJ.
That video was hilarious. How's everybody doing? I'm Miles, this is Layla, and this is Lena. We wanted to give our dad a happy birthday.
Thank you, son.
Now, I remember, one thing that you do for me is that you give me the pride in being a Johnson. So whether it's playing soccer on the soccer field, whether I scored a goal or got an assist, he's always saying, what's your name? I say, I'm a Johnson. Or if I'm in school and I get all A's or I get a good grade on an exam or whatever, he always says, what's your name? I say, I'm a Johnson. So, in every milestone I've had in my life, you've always been there for me. I just want to say thank you and happy birthday, old man.
Love you.
Okay, Miles, that was good. One thing I love about my dad is his Whole Foods addiction. He will come home from church at least once a week with a new snack, drink, or food that he just found and wanted to try. I remember we found this cream soda brand that we liked, and when I asked him to get more, my dad told me, they won't have any more until Wednesday. So then I asked, why do you know what day they restock cream soda at Whole Foods? And he just looked away.
So, you see, my dad is always learning and looking for new things to try, read, and do. He is always encouraging us to do the same. Happy birthday, Daddy. I love you.
Love you, too.
All right, it's my turn. Daddy, I love how caring you are and how much love and effort you put into your work. Like when I was in first grade and Mommy was away on a business trip and nobody was there to do my hair, but then you came in with the brush and rubber band and started doing it. And while it was definitely not the best, you put a lot of love and effort into it. Or like when I won first place at the Carver Science Fair, or when I was competing in my robotics competition. You would get up from your chair with your phone horizontally held, walking up and down the aisles, ducking under ropes to get the best picture that you could. And so later, you could show on Facebook how proud you were of me. It's the little things that you do that show how important we are to you. You're all important, and you are important to us.
Aww. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Dad.
And Pastor, so this is just a little appreciation gift that has some really great stuff in there. We want you to enjoy it because we here at Dare to Imagine appreciate you more than we say. If we could, we'd give you the world. But since we can't do that, we gave you just a little token, and we can't wait for you to open it up. Please give it up for the best pastor in the world. Pastor KJ, and can we go ahead and sing our song? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. One more time. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. You are the best because I know y'all don't know the first verse. So. Pastor, you are the best pastor in the world. We really do appreciate you. So you enjoy everything in here. You deserve some well time off.
Thank you.
Yes, of course. Of course. Amen. Amen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is that time where we are getting ready for the word. And I just want to go ahead. Let's set our minds. Let's get our hearts ready to prepare for the word that God has given to Pastor KJ on this morning. Amen. Amen.
Miracles when you move, such a funny thing for you to do. Your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus, and your voice is calling me out. And right now I know you're able, and my God, come through again. You that God can do all things. You can do all things but fail, cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know you never will. If you know that the battle is not yours and it belongs to the Lord, I want you to stand on your feet, cause we all know this song and I want you to sing it with me. Hallelujah. Everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. A new wind is blowing right now. Breaking my heart of stone, taking over like it's Jericho. And my walls are all crashing down. Right now, I know you're able. And my you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. you've never lost a battle. And I know, you never will, yeah. You can do all things, 'cause God can do all things. You can do all things, but fail, 'cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know, you never will. I know, you never will. I know, you never will, yeah. 'Cause we know that the battle is not ours, because it belongs to the Lord. And if you believe that, I need you to declare it, say hallelujah. Oh, he never lost a battle. He never will. He never will. Hey, woo! I don't know about you, this song gets me so excited. Oh, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never will. Oh, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. And you never will. You never lost a battle. And you never lost a battle. Oh, you never lost a battle. And he never will. Oh, and I know you won't lose. And I know he won't lose. And I know he won't lose. 'Cause he never will.
Let's give the Lord some praise today. You're glad to be here today. Come on, let's lift up the name of Jesus. For my Bible tells me that if we lift him up, that all will bow down to Jesus. Come on and lift up the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. I want to thank you all so much. Can y'all just give it up for the team and for everybody who has made this such a special day? Can y'all just give it up for them? Give them an emoji clap. Thank you all so much. Thank you, Kimya. Thank you, my children. Love them dearly. Thank you, staff. They just did an awesome, awesome job. And the man who just took away the whole show, that is Wayne. Come on, give it up for Wayne. Y'all go ahead and direct the camera over here to Wayne. He's on this camera over here. Thank God for this young brother. He is always involved with helping around here at the church. And I did not know that he could add to his resume now that he is an actor too. Amen. He had me down to the T, from my laughs to just everything. And so I'm just so thankful to each and every one of you. And y'all know that I love you so much. And what I want you to do, I really am the one who lifts the offering. And one is because I want to make sure we make that appeal to you. And they were like, Pastor, we got it. And I said, okay, I'm a little nervous. And looking at some of the numbers, I am a little nervous. So y'all better make sure that you give. I'm talking to everybody online. Amen. Amen. We got snow outside, and we got to make sure that we remove this. And I want to make sure that we give to the glory of God. And I encourage you to give the way that I give, and that is via PushPay. And all you have to do is a text D2I Church app to 77977. There's a word today from the Lord. How many of you are ready to hear God's word today? Come on and give God some praise. And so I am thankful to each and every one of you. And there's a word today from the Lord that I want to share with you, coming from the book of Isaiah. We have been in the midst of this sermon series called Level Up. Somebody shout Level Up. Put it right there in the chat. Now y'all going to make me self-conscious every time I say put it right there in the chat. But put it right there in the chat, Level Up. And I want you to turn with me now to Isaiah chapter 40. Isaiah chapter 40. And we're going to lift up a couple verses. See, I'm going to start first with this 27th verse, because this is a verse that really lays out the foundation for Isaiah 28 through 31, which I'll talk about a little bit later in the sermon. But I want you to hear this, because when the prophet Isaiah is speaking, he is speaking to the children of Israel. He is saying to them that it's time for you to level up. Have you ever met somebody who you know needed to go to the next level in their life? Have you ever met somebody who you know were kind of stuck where they are? Well, this is a scripture that deals with trying to help all of us level up. And we're in the midst of this series for this entire year. This is our theme, Level Up. And I want to encourage you to make sure that you sign up right there, d2ic.org/level up, because I want you to grow spiritually. I want you to grow personally. I want you to grow professionally. I want you to grow in service, and I want you to grow in your generosity. This is going to be an awesome year for you, and I believe that God's going to do some great things if you and I take that first step and level up. So let's hear what the Word of God says here in the text in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 27. And it says, "Why do you complain, Jacob? Why do you say, Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord? My cause is disregarded by my God. Why do you complain, Jacob? Why do you say, Israel, why my way is hidden from the Lord? My cause is disregarded by my God." And then look at what God says to him before this is articulated. He says here in verses 25 to 26, "To whom will you compare me? Oh, or who is my equal, says the Lord, the Holy One. Lift up your eyes and look to the heavens, who created all these, he who brings out the starry hosts one by one and calls forth each of them by name. Because of his great power and mighty strength, not one of them is missing." And I want to talk today from the subject of level up your life. Come on, say with me, put it right there in the chat. Level up your life. Come on and say it like you really mean it. Level up your life. You know, research shows that 3% of Americans, they set goals for their life. And what's interesting is that when you look at those 3% of Americans who set goals for their lives, they achieve 97% of the goals that they set. How many of us are living lives in which we have not set any goals? How many of us are living lives in which we have not looked at where we are and where God wants us to be? But as I look at where we are right now in our world and in our current circumstance, I am convinced that God wants you to level up your life. Yes, for many of us, we spend our time looking at everybody else. We look at how Oprah has leveled up. We look at how Beyonce has leveled up. We look at how Jay-Z has leveled up. We look at how Bloomberg has leveled up. We look at how everybody else has leveled up in their lives. And the question that ought to come to you, when are you going to level up? When are you going to step up? When are you going to go to the next level in your life? Yes, when we look here in the book of Isaiah, I love this text because Isaiah deals with the fact that the children of Israel, they had experienced some dark days in their lives. They had experienced some changes in their life circumstances. But Isaiah starts off Isaiah chapter 40, and he says, "Comfort, oh comfort ye people." And he begins to make this shift, and he says to them that now it's time for you to level up. Now it's time for you to go to the next level. Now it's time for you to realize your full potential. And what I've discovered about so many of us, and the reason that we cannot level up, it is because we have been stuck in a season in which we complain about everything that has ever happened in our lives. We complain about our job. We complain about our boo. We complain about our neighbors. We complain about every situation. And I just came by here to tell somebody that if you are going to level up in your life, life, the first thing that you have to start doing is to stop complaining. Come on, I wish I had a witness in here today. Touch somebody right now. Oh, don't touch him right now. I forgot about COVID season. But just go ahead and put it right there in the chat. Stop complaining. Yes, this is the first thing I want to share with you today, is that we have to learn how to stop complaining. When we look here in Isaiah 40, and I hope they'll put it right there in the lower third, stop complaining, is that the first thing that we see here in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 27, is that Isaiah is the type of brother who ends up speaking truth to power. He says to Jacob, "Why do you complain? Why do you say, Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord? My cause is disregarded by my God." You see, you have to understand what God is saying through the prophet Isaiah to Jacob. He says, "Why do you complain, Jacob?" That's the old you. And then he says, "Why do you say, Israel, my way is hidden?" It's because you got to remember that God changed Jacob's name to Israel. And it was there that late night when Jacob was wrestling with God that he says, "I'm not going to let you go until you bless me." And sometimes God can bless you and you're still complaining. Sometimes God can move in your life and you're still talking about what you don't have. And sometimes you and I have to sit back and look at how the Lord has blessed us. Look at how the Lord keeps opening up doors. Look at how the Lord keeps making a way. Look at how the Lord keeps making mountains move. And look at how the Lord begins to raise up valleys. And stop complaining and start praising God right now. So many of us complain. So many of us spend our lives talking about what we don't have instead of just looking around and seeing what we do have. If you and I would do what our ancestors would say, count our many blessings and name them one by one, it would surprise you to see what the Lord has done. See, Jacob, according to Isaiah, had spent his time complaining and talking about what he did not have. And God says here, stop complaining. Why do you complain? And then there is this second point that I want to share with you today. It's not only must you stop complaining, but you and I must understand this, is that we must let go of the things that keep holding us back. Come on, put it right there in the chat. Let go of the things that keep holding you back. You know, when I think about this, I'm reminded of this anonymous quote that said, "Life isn't about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself." I'm going to say it again. Life is not about finding yourself, but life is about creating yourself. And what I've discovered about some of us, and the reason that we cannot create the self that God has for us, it is because we don't want to let some things go that keep holding us back. And so therefore, you will never walk into your season. You will never move into your season of destiny as long as you keep allowing for things to hold you back. And you know, I looked at what took place with the Eagles since it's Super Bowl Sunday. And the brother, they'll tell him in a few minutes, but you know the brother who was there with the Eagles, who had been looked over, he finally got to the point. He said, "Listen, I'm never going to become head coach right here." He said, "In fact, if I stay here, I might just dig my grave." And so what he does is he decides to leave, because he realizes that there are some people who are never going to see the anointing that's on your life. There are some people who are never going to recognize how God is going to bless your life. And sometimes you got to let go of those things that are holding you back. What's holding you back? What's keeping you from reaching your full potential? What is that thing that has the best of you God says to you in this season, let go of those things that keep holding you back. So you know that there are things that are holding you back, that every time you say, look, I'm going to do something, somebody comes around and tries to tell you why you can't do it. Every time you decide that you're going to go ahead and apply for that job, or that you're going to go ahead and make that move, somebody always comes along and tries to hold you back. I was talking to one of our members yesterday. He and his wife, they're moving down to North Carolina. And he talked about how there were always different circumstances that were preventing them from making this move down south. And he said, then finally, they just had to get to the point to say, look, we can't let anything hold us back. And when you know that God has something with your name on it, don't you let no devil in hell, don't you let no enemy, don't you let no naysayer hold you back from how God is about to move in your life. The third thing I want to share with you today as we talk about leveling up your life, it is this, is that we must improve the way you talk to yourself. Somebody put it right there in the chat. Improve the way that you talk to yourself. Jack Canfield once said this. He says, you only have control over three things in your life. Your thoughts, the thoughts you think, the images you visualize, and the actions you take. He says, you only have control over three things: the thoughts you think, the images you realize, and the actions you take. Some of us, you need to learn how to talk to yourself. In fact, one songwriter said it this way: encourage yourself. You see, many of us, we are waiting for somebody else to talk to us. We're waiting for somebody else to encourage us. We're waiting for somebody else to validate us. But I've learned a long time ago that you cannot wait for somebody else to motivate you. You can't wait for somebody else to speak life into you. You can't wait for somebody else to give you what you need. No, in fact, if you really know who you really are, you won't even turn to somebody else. You'll turn to the Word of God. And you'll remember what God says right there in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5, in which he says, before you were born, I knew you. In other words, beloved, there's some of us right now that when you look at the Word of God, God will remind you that all that you need and all that you need in your life, I have already given you, because God has already thought about you. Yes, when I begin to look over my life and look at how I've made it through different situations, I'm reminded of what Isaiah says right there in chapter 55, that my ways are not your ways, and my thoughts are not your thoughts. And God makes it abundantly clear that for some of us, we have to learn how to talk to ourselves so that we can speak life into our minds, our hearts, and our souls. Improve, if you're going to level up your life, improve the way that you talk to yourself. You ought to get up in the morning and say, you look good. Some folk, they wait for everybody else to tell them that they look good. No, tell yourself, you look good. In fact, don't wait for somebody else to tell you that you're smart. Read a book, and then you'll start knowing that you're becoming smart. In fact, don't wait for somebody else to tell you that you're doing well. No, you know yourself. And you and I have to learn how to speak life into ourselves so that we can become who God wants us to be. Improve the way that you talk to yourself. I've seen so many people, they get down on themselves until they get into this rut, until they cannot live the life that God wants them to have. Then lastly, I want to share this with you. If you're going to level up in your life, then you must understand this fourth thing, and that is this, is that you must make choices and decisions that align with the bigger vision for your life. How many of you know that God has a vision for you? Come on here in the sanctuary. If you're online, go ahead and raise your hand with an emoji. How many of you know that God has something bigger for your life? You see, when I look here in Isaiah and I look at this text, I'm reminded that Isaiah could not really help the people the way he wanted to is because they were stuck in a particular mindset and they were complaining and they were looking at their lives and saying, God, why did you allow for these things to happen to us? And Isaiah reminds them here in the text. He says to them, as I quoted earlier from Isaiah 55, that my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are my ways your ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. Yes, it is here when we look at this text that we begin to see that Isaiah is speaking life into the people. But what is most important is whether or not they see that God is trying to do something bigger in their lives. I'm reminded of this quote of Oprah Winfrey when she said, create the highest, grandest vision possible for your life because you become what you believe. In other words, if you don't believe in seeing anything in your life, you're never going to become anything. And that's why you got to surround yourself with people who believe like how you believe and who think like how you think and who act like how you act and who dream like how you dream, because you don't want to be around nobody who is a small thinker. You don't want to be around nobody who doesn't have a vision for their lives. You don't want to be around anybody who does not see what God is about to do in your life. You and I must make decisions and choices that align, watch this now, with the bigger vision for our lives. Isaiah says it this way in verse 28. He says, hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them who have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and become weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But he says, but they that what? Wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings as eagles. They shall run and not get weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Beloved, I just came by here to tell somebody here today that God wants you to level up, and he wants you to make decisions and choices that align with the bigger vision that God has for your life. Yes, this is your season. This is the time that God's about to open up doors. This is the moment that God is going to help you realize your dreams. But you and I must level up to where God is. Listen to what God says there. In verse 26, I want you to hear this. Because he says this, he says, lift up your eyes and look to the heavens. And what I've discovered about us is that the reason why our lives cannot level up to the vision, watch this, and I'm done after this, to the vision that God has for us is because we are looking down. And if you want what God has for you, you got to look up. You're going to catch it in a few minutes. Wayne, I want you to follow my eyes. When you're looking down, the camera goes down. And God says, you got to look up. The camera goes up. Let me do it again. When you're looking down, everything else is looking down. But when you start looking up, when you start believing, when you start dreaming, when you start believing, and when you start to have the faith, I want you to know that God is about to open up some things in your life that the world cannot hold you back because of what God is about to do in your life. God makes it clear, lift up your eyes and look to the heavens. And then he says, who created all these? He who brings out the starry host one by one, calls forth each of them by name because of his great power and mighty strength, and not one of them is missing. Beloved, that's the word for you today. Is that God has a vision for your life. God wants you to walk into your destiny. He wants you to level up your life. But the only way you're going to start doing that is that you got to start lifting up your eyes towards the heavens and know what Isaiah says. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? He said, there's no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them who have no might, and to them who have no might, he increases strength. But he says, but what they that what wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. Yes. Beloved, I firmly believe today that God's about to do something in your life. And God wants you to level up in your life. The doors of the church are open right now. Yes. There may be some man, some woman who's here in the sanctuary as we stand up on our feet. Or somebody who is watching online. And you've been looking for a place where you can be. You've been looking for someone who can serve as your pastor, and I certainly want to be your pastor, and I want Dare to Imagine to be your church, and I want to encourage you right now to go to d2ic.org/join and be a part of what God is doing right here. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. God, we thank you right now. We thank you for every blessing. We thank you for every mountain. We thank you for every valley. And God, I declare right now, today, that you are going to level up in our lives. Use us right now, oh God, for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Love you much. See you this coming Wednesday, devotion and dialogue. Come on and stretch out your hands and let's say together, we know that life is better when we dare to imagine. Amen. 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 Amen.
Good morning, Dare to Imagine. What a fantastic time to celebrate our pastor, Pastor KJ. I think back to the time that we as a family came to know the pastor and his wife, Kenya. It was a time that we spent together at Uncle Bobby's. We shared lattes, we exchanged stories, and we got to hang out with our special ladies. What a treat.
The thing that comes to mind when I think of Pastor KJ is the fact that he is a pastor to the people. Even in the midst of all of this COVID and not being able to gather the way we would like to traditionally, he still is able to maintain a personal touch, and I think that's just part of who he is, and we appreciate that.
Pastor, I just want to say thank you for all you do for us here at Dare to Imagine Church. Thank you for who you are, and just want to wish you a healthy, happy birthday. I pray that God beyond blesses you for your special day and the year to come. Happy, happy birthday. You deserve every good thing.
And so to honor our pastor, the pastor that gives so much to us, I think it's time that we really show our appreciation and give to him. And so I'm asking you, church, to take the time and text D2I Church app to 77977 to give to the pastor love offering. Pastor KJ, Leukemia and Dare to Imagine Church. We love you and we appreciate you.
Amen. What an amazing service. And I love any chance this church and our community gets the chance to celebrate our beloved pastor, Dr. Johnson. Just from the bottom of our heart, just thank you for everything that you are. I challenge everybody to right now jump on Pushpay. We got to hit up a love offering just to show and give back to the man who gives so much to our church.
Absolutely. That pastoral love offering is important as we demonstrate our love and appreciation for our pastor and all that he has done here for our community at Dare to Imagine Church.
Amen. Like I said, what an amazing service and an amazing Sunday here at Dare to Imagine. We hope that you enjoyed connecting with us, and we want to continue to learn how we can pour into you and bring out your spiritual gifts. So we challenge you right now to connect with our Director of Engagement and Development, Christine Dancy.
Yes, as we've said before, Christine Dancy is a blessing here at Dare to Imagine Church, as she will help you navigate through all of the community involvement that we have and anything that will help direct your path as you navigate here through Dare to Imagine.
Absolutely. And with this Level Up series that Pastor has rolled out in 2021, all of January and now into February, it's really challenging us to really grow and level up.
Yes, absolutely. So Wallace, how are you leveling up in your faith?
I've been working on prayer, but I'm trying to stay in the word as well.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, me too. I'm trying every day to at least, you know, pray and read a word just to keep that on my mind and afresh. So, yeah.
Absolutely.
So we want to know what you guys are going to be doing to level up in your faith. So go ahead right now, drop in the chat how you're going to be leveling up in your faith. And, oh, by the way, we gotta give some gifts out, huh?
Oh, we sure do. Let me pull out our notes. Yes. So our four winners out are Michelle Bryson, yay, Mark Graves, my bro W.L. Green, and Kevin M. Williams. Congratulations. You're going to connect with us. You're going to get some swag on the way.
Yes. So you guys got those awesome swag coming your way because we got those answers wrong earlier. So thank you for tuning in and enjoy your gear.
Absolutely. So before we go, we want to, as always, give you the chance to make the best decision of your life by accepting Jesus into your heart and into your spirit.
So right now, I encourage you to repeat after me. Dear God.
Dear God.
I believe that you are the Christ.
I believe that you are the Christ.
And the Son of the living God.
And the Son of the living God.
You died on the cross for my sins.
You died on the cross for my sins.
And rose again to give us new life.
And rose again to give us new life.
Today I place my faith and trust in you.
Today I place my faith and trust in you.
So come into my life and make me new.
So come into my life and make me new.
So I can follow you.
So I can follow you.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. So let's end it how we always do, right?
All right.
We know that life is better when we what?
Dare to imagine.
We'll see you next week.
See you next week.